Hello and welcome everybody, and thank you guys for joining me again. My name is Wilkie and I'm back with the promised new and freshly coming For Honor videos. And I'm back with the Orochi. As I said, it's probably gonna be either Orochi or Nobushi of the heroes I'm gonna be playing. So yeah, I'm not entirely sure which one it's gonna be in the end, but whatever it is, it's most likely gonna be one of these two. That was a nice parry, actually. As you can see, I'm still a bit I guess not really used. Ooh, I'm actually dead. Unless he. No. I do have to get back to learning how to play For Honor properly again. It's not that I forgot it, but you know, practice does play a very huge role in games like that. So, I mean, I whiffed a couple top lights, and to be honest, I'm not sure because some people still believe Orochi's cancer for whatever reason, but I don't really understand why. I mean, he's not that strong compared to the rest of the cast, so. Oh wow, that was interesting. He's good at parrying, actually. I should stop following up. And I should also start deflecting. Because, that way I can at least get close, but okay. And whoa, that was a good parry, damn it. There we go. There we go. I'm not sure, like, the thing is, as I said, I played Warden in the betas, but Warden is. Well, Warden is broken. Or it's not broken, but it's S tier, and I don't like S tier characters. Warlord is gonna get changed, Conqueror, meh. And Peacekeeper has been even banned in some tournaments, so that's kind of a bit ridiculous. But, okay, I mean, why the hell not? Actually, can't. He cannot parry that, I think. That's very good. This guard break after that works so well, I'm not sure why, but okay. Yeah, he can't parry that apparently. Wow. Wowzers. Faggot scrub. What the hell? Wow. What? I don't even get it. What? Why was he so salty? Come on. I wasn't even playing that good, nor was I abusing. Well, Orochi has nothing really to abuse. I mean, sure, you can go, like, cancel this and, like, blah blah blah, but come on. Orochi is probably one of the fairest characters in the game compared to others, so I'm not sure why people are so mad about it. Oh well. Let's just finish the bot real quickly. And I should stop trying to garp rank Nobushi's, but okay. Yeah, like I said, not sure. The thing about Nobushi is I like her a lot, but I kind of find her damage a bit too hard on the bleed. Like, if she gets bleed on an enemy and she trucks you with a heavy attack, it probably, I think it deals like 50 damage or so. It hits really hard due to her passive that she deals more damage against enemies that bleed, which makes her really good in duels, actually. And I actually like her hidden stance thingy. But I'm not entirely sure. For now, I'm gonna switch between Orochi and Nobushi until I figure out where I really want to be, or maybe even another hero. I'm not entirely sure. With the upcoming reworks of Warlord, at least they start to address some of the issues. But well, I mean, it's gonna take time. Nobody's expecting wonders. I mean, it's a wonder that they actually did come out with new and good information. The only real concern is, will they actually push through, or will we have to wait for God knows how long, another, I don't know, announced community blackout or something else? So, and they still haven't fixed that thingy, like if somebody leaves during the game, it's probably gonna take a few more seconds. There we go. So let's go for more duels and see how long the queue takes. Like, the salt is getting realer in For Honor lately. It's been quite heavy. Like, even as we saw, like, this guy just completely went nuclear for some reason. I had another game where I was playing Shigoki, and the guy was tilted as hell, even though I wasn't even using any Shigoki techs or, like, anything that Shigoki makes really, like, stand out. So, I'm not entirely sure why those people are getting increasingly salty. I mean, I get why they get salty if you play, like, Peacekeeper, Warden, Conqueror, Warlord, or anything, and just like spam the hell out of them, just go super cheesy, and just, well, make use of why these heroes are S tier. But yeah, It still seems to be in the mindset of a lot of people that other heroes are also cancer, like apparently Orochi. And I had this conversation with another friend of mine that he also believes that Orochi is probably one of the most balanced heroes, and I think so too. Like, he's an assassin, he's not overly fast, but he's quick, he's nimble, he does hurt a lot, but in return, he does have low stamina, and he doesn't have a lot of HP, so it's pretty much what an assassin should be. So, minus the still not fixed zone attack issue, but I'm not using that really, or at least not willingly. Sometimes it happens, even to me if I forget to like think about it and not do it. But I will make a follow-up video explaining how or what the problem is with the zone attacks in the future. Just need to record proper footage. So let's go for the Berserker Badaka. Oh, nice feint, but not again. Oh damn, that parry, he's gonna knock me to the wall and get a free top heavy. Yikes, that damage is so horribly hard, but he did the same mistake again. I'm not entirely sure what Orochis can actually do if you knock somebody on the ground, to be honest, but yeah. How to open? Oh, wait. Oh. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. I should start using Riptide more often, especially after they buffed it. I'm still not sure if it actually disjoints. Like, you have the problem that guard breaks, certain moves will, like, follow and, like, trace the enemy. So if you move away at the right time, or rather, if the enemy guard breaks at the right time and you dash away, he will still fall up. So I cannot cancel that. Yeah. Yeah, why should that work? I mean, yeah. Oh, damn it. I should not. What? Okay, fair enough. Fair game. I'm surprised Guard Break works after Orochi's top light because it's like the most used follow-up after his top light chain. I just use it for fun, really. Because it puts kind of pressure on the enemy, but at the same time, I don't really understand why they would not counter it. It's probably because they want to punish themselves or something. I'm not entirely sure. I should also use, like, his dash attacks because they actually aren't bad. Oh, nice parry. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh. He's actually getting a bit better with the feints, but. No, that's not what I wanted to do. Damn it, I'm dead. Dang it, I should not do that. That's the only thing I don't like about Orochi, but that's a general problem for any hero that does not have any unblockable or any way to really open up people. If you're out of stamina, or if the enemy is out of stamina, and you play heroes that don't have any freaking unblockable orange attacks, you're just gonna stand there and wait for them to recover stamina, really? Like, nobody halfway decent is foolish enough to actually try to parry something they can just block. Like, for what reason? There's no reason to open up in that regard. But oh, his parries are on point, really. Ah, oh, there you go. Probably believes I'm gonna faint. See, that's so good. That's so good. It usually doesn't work twice, but sometimes it does, because, like, the thing is, the current meta, I think it's meta, I'm not entirely sure how you pronounce, I think it's meta, but whatever, is basically that you usually will not attack with a heavy unless you're sure it's gonna hit. So most people will not try to block it or something, but instead feint or something, or think you will feint, I don't know. It's just really strange, so. Whoopsie dipsie. That damage into a wall is so hardcore. It really hurts a lot. Oh. It's like two top heavies and I'm gonna be deleted, so. Oh. Oh, now he blocked at least. So. I'm dead. GG. That was actually kind of a mistake, I guess. I'm still a bit too shaky again because I'm not playing Orochi. all that often yet, at least. And most of the times I've just been playing around through various modes, so I'm not entirely up to date on how certain things work. I'm a bit better versed with Nabushi, but as I said, there have been hints that Nabushi is gonna get changed, and I'm afraid that they will rake her up to like top tier 2. Because honestly, Orochi has a mechanic that could potentially make her the strongest hero in the game, and I think it's the only hero that has a true iframe. But we're not gonna go Peacekeeper, but it's kind of tricky to use right now, and I think that's what they're gonna address. So they're gonna make it easier to use, or at least they said something in the dev stream that they plan to make the hidden stance easier to use. I'm not entirely sure what they mean by easier to use, because I don't find it particularly hard to use. So I'm not entirely sure what their rework plans are on that. And it's probably gonna take a while until we see that patch, so. Anyways, let's see what this guy is made of with the Kensei. Kensei's scary. But Kensei is a lot more passive than Berserker is, so. Oh, top heavy. Or top light, I mean. Oh man, this is so much more brutal for him now. Oh, nice parry. It's kind of sad that they fixed the cancel feint stuff, because that was really something Kensei could capitalize on. I get that it was kind of like a glitch or bug, but I mean, come on. Kensei's not really that strong, damn it. And like, he revolves a lot more about mind games than any other hero, to be honest. Like, if you're super aggressive and you let him get parries after parries into walls or something, then obviously Kensei is gonna truck you down very quickly, but if you don't, then it's pretty damn brutal for a Kensei to actually get anything done. So he's gonna feint? No. Okay. Oh, I should have parried that, actually. I think he doesn't understand that he can actually heavy after a light parry, which is incredibly strong on Kensei. He deals so much damage with that move. I'm faster. Well, not really faster, but he's not gonna parry, is he? I don't get it, but okay. Just gonna smack swords together then. Fair game. Go full anime move. That move is incredibly frustrating if you like land it, because it opens so much damage. And there's one of the key features that you can't actually parry the follow-up. So even if the enemy does not get hit, or just blocks Riptide, it's not Riptide, it's Storm Surge Rush thingy. I have to look it up. I'm not entirely sure what the name actually is. Uh-oh. No, dude. Oh, wait. Ah, come on. Hey. That's not nice. Damn it. That's not nice at all. That's kind of scary about Kensei, but as I said, that's just really, if you don't follow the defensive whatever. The defensive, whatever the name is, like, if you just turtle, there's nothing Kensei can do, really. He can just feint all he wants, you can just block everything, and he's not gonna get jack shit done. But that's kind of boring, so, I'm not really interested in doing that, so. He's gonna feint, and then, oh no, he's not gonna feint, okay. For a game. That was a good feint, actually. He's good on the feints into something else, like, a lot of people don't really do that. So let's see you. Ooh, it's gonna go. That was kind of obvious, wasn't it? But for some reason, when Kensei moves, you just be like, I can punish, I can punish, I can punish. But yeah, well, let's see if he's up for another round. I'm actually not really showcasing good play there, but I mean, that's also part of the process, really. Let's see if he stays for another round. Good. And we can play. And I'm gonna cut the video down. As I said, I'll try to record Overwatch gameplay maybe this week. I'm not entirely sure when I will have the time to do so. But I'm not entirely sure. Like, the thing is, Overwatch, I'm not entirely sure how to actually make it. I'll probably have to start chopping down the videos, because I like death scenes, teammates talking, or I'm not entirely sure how good the content is gonna come out in terms of like entertainment purpose. Because I don't think, well, I could potentially make guides on Overwatch 2, but come on, the game is relatively old, so I don't really think there's reason or like market for that really. But oh no, thank you. Oh nice. Uh-oh. Don't worry, I'm not gonna knock it. Fuck. I actually forgot that fucking heavies knock off the fucking edge, but like, I should have gone for a top light. Fuck's sake. God, that was so annoying. Shit. I didn't want to do that. I fucking hate environmental kills, and sorry for swearing, but that was absolutely not my plan. Like, Jesus Christ. No, okay. He's gonna feint and then he's gonna swing through. Oh, never mind. Oh, that's something that is very, very punishable. Like, super punishable. Oh, that was good. He's gonna feint and then he's usually feinting and then pulling through. Why does he do that again? Like, huh? Damn. Feint and then top light, quick top light. Good. If I'm gonna win the next round, I'm gonna give it one win because, like I said, that was not something I hated. And I totally forgot because, yeah. I mean, I could have knocked him down with a grab itself, but I didn't obviously do that. But meh, maybe he believes me, maybe he doesn't. I'm not entirely sure. Wanna be an honorable. Ooh, damn it. Honorable opponent and not like a scrub that knocks people down. Oh, that was a good mix-up, actually. Like, I expected the same direction. So, feint and then. Oh. Why does he knock into the wall? I don't get it. I'm pretty sure he knows that. Like, he can get a free top heavy after he knocks me into the wall, so. Oh, I'm dead. I should stop using it. Like, yeah. No. But let me take a look. It's Storm Rush and I think it's Riptide. It looks super good, but the risk is way too big and the reward is kinda meh. He has Riptide Strike and Storm Rush. Okay. So let's see. Oh. Guess that was a bit too obvious. Oh, he does actually know. Probably gonna wait for his HP to recover because he doesn't want to get chipped by light to death. So, I haven't used zone in ages, so that was kind of bleh though. All right, we're gonna go for another one. We're gonna go for another one, and hopefully I'm not gonna knock him down this time. It kind of pisses me off that I did that, really. Like, that was so disgusting. Okay, he's up for another one. Okay, this is the last one. No matter what freaking happens, I'll cut it. Like, the video is way too long already. Jesus Christ. I should really start editing it. But forgive me, my audience, I'm too lazy. It's not the cutting itself, but just like rendering after editing is just so tedious. Oh, damn it. Oh, I think I pissed him off. Holy shit. This is gonna be tedious as fuck now. I have very little experience against warlords, to be honest. Like, most of them I just face in Dominion, like the 4v4 modes, and they just freaking two-shot you there because they get revenge like after two hits, and they headbutt you to the ground and you're dead. But let's see what this guy's made of. Headbutt. Well, I didn't expect anything else really. Oh, he does faint though. It's interesting. I still don't know what to do with a Orochi after I can knock somebody to the ground. I really don't know. I hate this move so much. God damn it. The headbutt. The headbutt is real. Oh, wait, what? Trace? The tracks? That was interesting. I didn't know that. Thought I could sidestep it. Maybe I can if I sidestep to the right direction, but that was probably the wrong one. Yeah, warlords are kind of tedious. At least he doesn't abuse his headbutt the whole time, so. Oh, priority. Headbutt, yeah. And then he's gonna go. It's actually a very good feint combo. I can chip you away, dude. I don't care, really. Ah! It so throws me off that Warlord's feint, because most Warlords don't, for whatever reason. I mean, they have super armor, they don't really have to feint, because they will out-trade you very easily. So actually having somebody that feints is kinda weird. And hard to get used to, I guess. But that's good. I should actually just sidestep his headbutt, because he has a very predictable pattern when he does that, so. Yeah, I can't actually. See, that's what I mean. Like, super armor is just. Just tediously. See, I saw that one coming. Free game. Uh-oh. Hey, seriously. Oh well. Oh well, he kinda deleted me, but I didn't expect anything else. Anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed me, well, getting my ass kicked pretty damn badly on Orochi. And as always, see you guys next time.